everyone. I'd like to welcome you to this wonderful jewel of a school in this small community here in Shorter, Alabama. And I would like to invite you to sit back and relax and enjoy the wonderful presentation Mrs. Cannon and the sixth grade promotees have planned for you today. So, thank you for coming out this afternoon, and I assure you will enjoy all that's planned here. We've had a wonderful year in spite of the pandemic. COVID-19 has wreaked havoc on most of our lives, but we did well in spite of all of these challenges that we face, and that's what we've set out here to do, to ensure that your young ones are prepared for future challenges that they might face later on.
May we please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, promotees. It's my privilege and honor to bring you a word of inspiration. Inspiration is the process of being mentally stimulated to do or feel something, especially to do something creative. Every morning when I get up and I look in the mirror before I get dressed and get ready for work, it's a quote that I read. And the quote states, "Do something today that your future self will thank you for." I have found out that it is important in this journey of life that we must find something in the world worth fighting for. Pretty big. If you learn all you can, dream big, create a plan, be willing to work, and listen, you will have the tools to become anything you would like in life. Just because you have the tools doesn't mean everything is going to go your way. But the key is, will you use the tools that you have to pick yourself back up and get on your feet? Remember, anything worth having is worth fighting for. Always remember that the staff at Deborah Cannon Wolf love you, believe in you, and we also want you to succeed in life. Thank you.
Just ain't right. Follow me, I will be waiting. Brooks, principal, school board members, Mayor Powell, fellow teachers, parents, community members, and most of all, our outstanding sixth grade students. Thank you for being a part of this ceremony. Like you, I'm still trying to wrap my head around all that has happened this school year. It has definitely been a roller coaster of a year due to the COVID pandemic, but it has finally started to become somewhat normal again, so we can rejoice in knowing better days are coming. To our strong sixth grade student graduates, here we are. I know this is not the graduation that you dreamed of having. Like me, at the end of your kindergarten graduation, you could not wait for your next graduation, which in our part of the country is sixth grade. Like me, you imagine getting out of classes early for graduation rehearsal, telling your parents where to sit in the audience, looking out and seeing your whole family smiling and cheering for you, and planning that after party. I know, but know that your prior sixth grade class felt the same way, and that there are thousands of other sixth graders around the state feeling the exact same way. So look forward and do not lose that excitement, because in 2 short years, you will be able to live the dream, and your parents will make sure that your 8th grade graduation will totally be awesome. And in closing, just remember, a passport isn't just about traveling to places physically, but being able to travel in your hearts and minds with where you are going, because it's a different world from where you come from. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. Again, I'm here presenting this afternoon this special message to our wonderful class, the class of 2021 here at Deborah Cannon Wolf School. These sixth graders, just like many others that have gone before you, are very special to us and to the members of the Macon County Board of Education, Superintendent Brooks, the D.C. Wolf faculty and staff, honored guests, parents, and the proud members of the sixth grade promotion class of 2021. I give you this charge. This afternoon, my gift to you is that this speech will be very, very short. And this is a tribute to you. I'm keeping it short because I fully realize how eager and anxious you are to get on with your well-earned celebrations. You should celebrate. You are very eager to receive the certificates that we've prepared for you, and you've worked very hard for. You're eager to join your families and your friends to share your joy with them. You're eager to get started with your plans for the future, and this is as it should be, for moving you to the next level of your educational aspirations, which is by no means the end, but just the beginning of all of your tomorrows. Over the past several years, you've worked and studied, practiced and played, and grown mentally and physically. And now you're here, ready to begin your lives as middle schoolers in the secondary education arena. This will mean preparation for high school, for career tech avenues, dual enrollment, pre-college and advanced placement courses, honor societies, ROTC, band, cheerleading, sports competitions, choirs, foreign languages, ACT and SAT assessments, along with many other preparations for college, careers, and beyond. Many of these you have no knowledge of or had no experience with before, but I assure you're prepared to meet the challenges that you will be faced with doing your very best in all of these avenues of learning. Whatever course your future takes, it is my sincere hope that you will look back on your 7 years, K through 6 here, at Deborah Cannon Wolf as having prepared you, COVID-19 pandemic and all, to meet and deal with the challenges that life will present. On behalf of myself, the faculty and staff here at Deborah Cannon Wolf Elementary School, I wish to each and every one of you the happiness of a safe, healthy, productive, and prosperous life, the respect of your fellow human beings, and the love of your family. May the future be yours, and the best of luck and congratulations to the D.C. Wolf Elementary School Pirates Class of 2021. I applaud you.
Please give these students a round of applause as I present to you 2021 promotees of Deborah Cannon Wolf Elementary School. Jalen Anderson, Madison Bell, Carmen Cook, Andrelia Hale, LaKenya Hall, Michael Herbert, Jada Malloy, Zariah Medlock, Devin Mobley, Kalia Roberson, DeAndre Robinson, Caden Sally, Jaquan Tate, Alexander Townsend,
as we prepare to exit this wonderful afternoon program and celebration of our 2021 promotees, I'd like to say that I wish each and every one of you a wonderful, wonderful summer, and it's going to be very short because school will start back again the first week in August, and that time is going to be very, very short. But that in mind, I'd encourage you young ones to read as much as you possibly can this summer in preparation for the opening of school in the fall, because that reading will enhance your success in school next school year, 21-22. Parents, please monitor the use of the cell phones. Keep your children respectful of themselves and others. And I say again, I look forward to you returning to school in August, and over the summer, make certain that you register your students if you haven't done so already. For those who will be extending their learning time, make certain that they are here for the duration of that time, well into July. Again, thank you again for coming out and sharing this great experience of our, we're gonna be so very sorry to have them go on to middle school at Booker Washington. You know that that will be the site for the middle school next school year. So again, thank you, and congratulations, class of 2020.